What is cerebral palsy? Cerebral palsy, CP, is a group of disorders that affect a person's ability to move and maintain balance and posture. CP is the most common motor disability in childhood. Cerebral means having to do with the brain. Palsy means weakness or problems with using the muscles. CP is caused by abnormal brain development or damage to the developing brain that affects a person's ability to control his or her muscles. The symptoms of CP vary from person to person. A person with severe CP might need to use special equipment to be able to walk, or might not be able to walk at all and might need lifelong care. A person with mild CP, on the other hand, might walk a little awkwardly but might not need any special help. CP does not get worse over time, though the exact symptoms can change over a person's lifetime. All people with CP have problems with movement and posture. Many also have related conditions such as intellectual disability, seizures, problems with vision, hearing, or speech, changes in the spine such as scoliosis, or joint problems such as contractures. Causes and risk factors. CP is caused by abnormal development of the brain or damage to the developing brain that affects a child's ability to control his or her muscles. There are several possible causes of the abnormal development or damage. People used to think that CP was mainly caused by lack of oxygen during the birth process. Now, scientists think that this causes only a small number of CP cases. The brain damage that leads to CP can happen before birth, during birth, within a month after birth, or during the first years of a child's life, while the brain is still developing. CP related to brain damage that occurred before or during birth is called congenital CP. The majority of CP, 85% to 90%, is congenital. In many cases, the specific cause is not known. A small percentage of CP is caused by brain damage that occurs more than 28 days after birth. This is called acquired CP, and is usually associated with an infection, such as meningitis or head injury. Risk factors for congenital CP. Some things increase the chance that a child will have CP. These are called risk factors. It is important to remember that having a risk factor does not mean that a child will have CP. Some of the risk factors for congenital CP are low birth weight. Children who weigh less than 5.5 pounds, 2,500 grams at birth, and especially those who weigh less than 3 pounds 5 ounces, 1,500 grams, have a greater chance of having CP. Premature birth. Children who were born before the 37th week of pregnancy, especially if they were born before the 32nd week of pregnancy, have a greater chance of having CP. Multiple births. Twins, triplets, and other multiple births have a higher risk for CP, especially if a baby's twin or triplet dies before birth or shortly after birth. Some, but not all, of this increased risk is due to the fact that children born from multiple pregnancies are often born early or with low birth weight, or both. Assisted reproductive technology infertility treatments. Children born from pregnancies resulting from the use of some infertility treatments have a greater chance of having CP. Most of the increased risk is explained by preterm delivery or multiple births, or both. Both preterm delivery and multiple births are increased among children conceived with assisted reproductive technology infertility treatments. Infections during pregnancy. Infections can lead to increases in certain proteins called cytokines that circulate in the brain and blood of the baby during pregnancy. Cytokines cause inflammation, which can lead to brain damage in the baby. Fever in the mother during pregnancy or delivery also can cause this problem. Some types of infection that have been linked with CP include viruses such as chickenpox, rubella, German measles, and cytomegalovirus, CMV, and bacterial infections such as infections of the placenta or fetal membranes or maternal pelvic infections. Jaundice and Kernicterus. Jaundice is the yellow color seen in the skin of many newborns. Jaundice happens when a chemical called bilirubin builds up in the baby's blood. When too much bilirubin builds up in a new baby's body, the skin and whites of the eyes might look yellow. This yellow coloring is called jaundice. When severe jaundice goes untreated for too long, it can cause a condition called Kernicterus. This can cause CP and other conditions. Birth complications, detachment of the placenta, uterine rupture, or problems with the umbilical cord during birth can disrupt oxygen supply to the baby and result in CP. Some causes of acquired CP are infection. Infections of the brain, for example, meningitis or encephalitis during infancy. Injury. Injuries to the brain, for example, head injuries caused by motor vehicle crashes or child abuse. Problem with blood flow to the brain. Cerebrovascular accidents, for example, stroke or bleeding in the brain associated with a blood clotting problem. Blood vessels that didn't form properly, a heart defect that was present at birth, or sickle cell disease. Prevalence and characteristics. Cerebral palsy is the most common motor disability in childhood. Recent population-based studies from around the world report prevalence estimates of CP ranging from 1 to nearly 4 per 1,000 live births, or per 1,000 children. About 1 in 345 children, 3 per 1,000 8-year-old children in the United States have been identified with CP. The prevalence of CP is higher for children born preterm or at low birth weight. 58.9% of children with CP are able to walk independently, 7.8% walked using a handheld mobility device, and 33.3% had limited or no walking ability. CP has been found to be significantly more common among Black children than white children. Hispanic children and white children were about equally likely to have CP. Types of cerebral palsy. Doctors classify CP according to the main type of movement disorder involved. Depending on which areas of the brain are affected, one or more of the following movement disorders can occur. Stiff muscles, spasticity, uncontrollable movements, dyskinesia, poor balance and coordination, ataxia. Spastic cerebral palsy. The most common type of CP is spastic CP. Spastic CP affects about 80% of people with CP. People with spastic CP have increased muscle tone. This means their muscles are stiff, and as a result, their movements can be awkward. Spastic CP usually is described by what parts of the body are affected. Spastic diplegia. In this type of CP, muscle stiffness is mainly in the legs, with the arms less affected or not affected at all. People with spastic diplegia might have difficulty walking because tight hip and leg muscles cause their legs to pull together, turn inward, and cross at the knees, also known as scissoring. Spastic hemiplegia. This type of CP affects only one side of a person's body. Usually the arm is more affected than the leg. Spastic quadriplegia. Spastic quadriplegia is the most severe form of spastic CP and affects all four limbs, the trunk and the face. People with spastic quadriplegia usually cannot walk and often have other developmental disabilities, such as intellectual disability, seizures, or problems with vision, hearing, or speech. Dyskinetic cerebral palsy. People with dyskinetic CP have problems controlling the movement of their hands, arms, feet, and legs, making it difficult to sit and walk. The movements are uncontrollable and can be slow and writhing or rapid and jerky. Sometimes the face and tongue are affected and the person has a hard time sucking, swallowing, and talking. A person with dyskinetic CP has muscle tone that can change, varying from too tight to too loose, not only from day to day, but even during a single day. Ataxic cerebral palsy. People with ataxic CP have problems with balance and coordination. They might be unsteady when they walk. They might have a hard time with quick movements or movements that need a lot of control, like writing. They might have a hard time controlling their hands or arms when they reach for something. Mixed cerebral palsy. Some people have symptoms of more than one type of CP. The most common type of mixed CP is spastic dyskinetic CP. Early signs. The signs of CP vary greatly because there are many different types and levels of disability. The main sign that a child might have CP is a delay reaching motor or movement milestones, such as rolling over, sitting, standing, or walking. Following are some other signs of possible CP. It is important to note that some children without CP also might have some of these signs. In a baby younger than 6 months of age, his head lags when you pick him up while he's lying on his back. He feels stiff. He feels floppy. When held cradled in your arms, he seems to overextend his back and neck, constantly acting as if he's pushing away from you. When you pick him up, his legs get stiff and they cross or scissor. In a baby older than 6 months of age, she does not roll over in either direction. She cannot bring her hands together. She has difficulty bringing her hands to her mouth. She reaches out with only one hand while keeping the other fisted. In a baby older than 10 months of age, he crawls in a lopsided manner, pushing off with one hand and leg while dragging the opposite hand and leg. He scoots around on his buttocks or hops on his knees, but does not crawl on all fours. Screening and diagnosis. Diagnosing CP at an early age is important to the well-being of children and their families. Diagnosing CP can take several steps. Developmental monitoring. Developmental monitoring, also called surveillance, means tracking a child's growth and development over time. If any concerns about the child's development are raised during monitoring, then a developmental screening test should be given as soon as possible. Developmental screening. During developmental screening, a short test is given to see if the child has specific developmental delays, such as motor or movement delays. If the results of the screening test are cause for concern, then the doctor will make referrals for developmental and medical evaluations. Developmental and medical evaluations. The goal of a developmental evaluation is to diagnose the specific type of disorder that affects a child. Treatments and intervention services. There is no cure for CP, but treatment can improve the lives of those who have the condition. It is important to begin a treatment program as early as possible. After a CP diagnosis is made, a team of health professionals works with the child and family to develop a plan to help the child reach his or her full potential. Common treatments include medicines, surgery, braces, and physical, occupational, and speech therapy. No single treatment is the best one for all children with CP. Before deciding on a treatment plan, it is important to talk with the child's doctor to understand all the risks and benefits. Intervention services. Both early intervention and school age services are available through our nation's special education law, the Individuals with Disabilities Education Act, IDEA. Part C of IDEA deals with early intervention services, birth through 36 months of age, while Part B applies to services for school-age children, 3 through 21 years of age. Even if a child has not been diagnosed with CP, he or she may be eligible for IDEA services.